Taking your stream to the next level with Shadowplay alternatives, random stinger transition shuffling, advanced cursor tracking, and more, an entire world of untapped potential for OBS Studio awaits, and not enough people know about it. Today we're talking about 6 OBS Studio scripts to take your stream to the next level and go above and beyond to add new stuff to OBS. I'm Evils Vox, the stream professor, and OBS Studio version 21 introduced Lua and Python script support, and not enough people knew what to do with it at first. And I polled you all on the YouTube community tab about what stuff to cover, and some of you expressed that you had never even heard of it until I mentioned it, which means I have failed as the stream professor to inform you about OBS's capabilities. So let's crack open the functionality and reveal the possibilities at play here. This video is part 3 of a 3-part mini-series, but there are more parts coming, so check the playlist link below for parts 1 and 2 and get subscribed so you don't miss all of the releases. First up is random stinger transitions. This script automatically sets a new stinger transition every time you change scenes. If you've made or you're making a bunch of different stingers and you want to be able to mix it up every time you change scenes instead of repeating the same one over and over so that your viewers do not get bored, this can do it. But it's worth keeping in mind that the script only works by changing out the actual video file of your stinger. It doesn't actually change what transition is being selected, so the transition duration will have to be the same. This isn't too bad, especially if you're making transitions for this purpose, but if you have a bunch of transitions from different places or that you made with wildly different transition links, you could end up in an awkward position where one is cutting too early, one is cutting too late, yada yada. This also works with track mat enabled stingers as well. But again, settings have to remain consistent, and you can't mix track mat and non-track mat stingers together. Although I bet if we ping our buddy Exceldro, they might be able to come up with a way to make this as a plugin as well. OBS Play automatically sorts and renames your recorded clips based on your scene names. This helps keep your files organized, akin to NVIDIA Shadowplay, but with the full audio track and customizability of OBS. I have a video on building the ultimate Shadowplay alternative with OBS Studio soon, so get subscribed. It goes pretty in depth. Unfortunately, there's nothing here to detect what game you're running and change it based on that, but if you have different scenes for your games, or at least you know to separate your webcam and gameplay videos, that's still an organization boost. Visibility Timer lets you show and or hide specific sources after a specified time and repeat that action, including delays, duration control, etc. This allows you to set up automated source toggling for dynamic camera angles so that it's changing angles every so often so your viewers can stay entertained, on-screen graphics, and so on. And you can have a really dynamic stream experience with minimal input from you, the streamer. That's what's really cool about this, is you don't have to sit there and change all of this with the move transition, it just does it on its own based on timing. This is similar to Nerderdy's Media Looper that I showcased a while back, but that was best suited to specific graphics situations and does that task better, whereas this is more broadly applicable and you could use it for camera angles and things like that. I have a pair of scripts for those of you who make tutorials, screencasts, or teach. The first is Zoom and Follow. This script lets you set up hotkeys to zoom in towards the mouse cursor, as well as follow it as you move it across the screen. You can choose specific sources to zoom in on and how much zoom you want. This is perfect if you have high-resolution monitors or need to show tiny details on screen, such as OBS UI elements, and don't want to have to do a ton of zoom in work during editing. I used to get a lot of comments asking how I was zooming in or out on my tutorials live in OBS, and at the time I was like, lol, I'm not, I'm just editing. Now you have an option. I'm actually working on setting this up with foot pedals to vastly speed up my tutorial recording. Stay tuned for that. To go another step and beyond that, we have the OBS Studio Mouse Cursor Skin. This will follow your mouse cursor and apply additional cursor overlays, such as a red circle or a yellow circle with transparency, green highlighting circle, and so on. This gets OBS one step closer to that little classic Camtasia tutorial recording experience, which is actually really great for those of you who want that added control that OBS provides while still making high quality tutorials that are easier to follow for the viewers. Because I will say, it's a lot of extra work that I have to do in editing to basically replicate that kind of experience. Our last script is one that I'm actually still trying to get additional resources built for, but I wanted to go on and mention it. I had it built by a subscriber, the Pokemon HUD for OBS. This allows you to set up automatic Pokemon swapping for your party display for Pokemon Let's Plays. It pulls the animated GIFs from Pokemon Showdown, automatically updates when you change a text file to indicate your party, you know, what Pokemon are in your party, whether you've got shiny Pokemon, and things like that. Like I said, I'm working on building a few more resources to make this the ultimate tool for Pokemon Let's Players, so stay tuned for a full video on this, but if you want to go on and play with it, link will be in the description below. If you're watching this and have thought of some cool script ideas that haven't been made yet, I seriously encourage you to contribute them back to the community. It's the only way that any of this was possible in the first place. Learning to script and improving your skills for future projects is actually pretty easy with Skillshare. Skillshare is an awesome online learning community where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. They have thousands of inspiring classes on topics such as productivity, film, video, photography, and even web development. Skillshare is for beginners, pros, dabblers, and masters who want to improve their skill set and learn a new skill entirely. No matter your goals, Skillshare has classes to fit your schedule and skill level. If you want to do what I do, I highly recommend checking out the YouTube course from Marques Brownlee, or MKBHD. It's got some good stuff in there. I actually really enjoyed seeing how his team's workflow works as well. The first 1,000 people to sign up with my link in the video description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare Premium. So don't miss out, check it out. What cool OBS scripts have you come across that weren't mentioned here? Let us know over on Discord at discord.gg/evosvox. Consider checking out this other video on how to build a live stream show for Twitch or YouTube to make better content in the first place. Remember, be kind, rewind.